this here, just curl your body. We'll do about 20 of these. Slowly. You're working down to your back. Grab your hand behind your back like this. You feel a little, when your neck goes around, you get okay, watch. You won't feel so much if you pull back, go around. You don't hear it as much? Other side. From side to side. Go down as far as you can.
If you touch the ground, fine. If not, don't worry about it. It'll come.
Okay. If you can't touch the ground, don't worry about it.
It'll come.
Without bending your knees. Okay, don't worry about that. Come back up. Our way down to your back.
And these exercises seem like nothing. But you'll be doing them when you're 7, or your friends will be sitting in the chair.
When
you want to do
cartwheels,
keep your wrists.
It's all going to be coming out in the wall. Just completely relax your body. You put your feet together. Don't grab the back of your head, but just this. And lean back a little bit. Just a little bit. Okay, we can face it. Put your feet together. Okay, don't hold your head. Just hold. If it hurts, stop. Six. minute anything hurts,
stop.
But you feel your kidneys and your liver being massaged by your body. Not your waist, but your hand. There you go.
Turning the weight and keeping
okay,
it on.
Let's pull this way first. Bring your knee. Shift your weight. Good. Hold on. And keep your hand in the same position. Exactly. It's like you're pulling something. Relax.
That's the hard
part. I know you're on. That makes you. Okay, let's stop for a minute and explain what you're doing. When you do this, this side is hurt, right? Okay, when you do that, I have arthritis. So when you do this, what you're doing is put an equal weight. You're equalizing the weight. So you, when you get hurt, you begin to focus on the part that hurt. This evens out the hurt. It evens out the, you know? Okay, once again, let's start. We're going to go, me and you, we'll go this way, she's going to help you. Change at the end and goes high. Exactly that.
It's a high block and a low block. It's a high block.
You're trying to keep somebody from kicking your head.
So your hand, lower hand is down. Perfect. You're trying to keep somebody from kicking.
But remember, you're shifting your weight. Thank you. shoulders?
No, I don't feel it in the back when I'm doing this.
Mm-hmm. But you felt that upper thigh. But it's all connected. Do it all one more time. Endorphins, the thing that helps you get over the pain, rushes to your foot. And you say, ooh, ow, 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 and it goes away. This is the same thing. Your back is hurt, so you want to have chemicals and juice
inside.
Go to that area to cool it out.
Stop hurting.
I mean, you can't rush it. You want to, ooh, get well. No. It doesn't work like that.
No.
Your body is marvelous. It can heal itself.
You know?
I was telling him about your sciatica.
Oh, yeah, that was bad.
You know, this woman, I looked at her one day and thought, oh, she's going to be crippled for the rest of her life.
I thought, too, and then I said, no, I'm not. I'm going to do everything I can to get it well.
Let's go to
that really works your spine.
Okay, you feel your spine?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do it again.
Is it pain?
Yes.
Is it pain? Now stop.
Okay, let's stop.
Mm-hmm.
Now, not to, but what happens if your bone will get hot here? Yeah.
Right.
You feel your tailbone get hot?
The big doctor showed him how to do this at the hospital. So you press on your knee, but you don't try to break your knee.
Well, you did it as a martial art, and little boy asked the teacher one day, can I break my leg? So if you want to. On the balls of your feet.
Mm-hmm.
Put your big feet together.
This one I found good, and you bounce on your toes. And for me, it helped my hip when it was hurting. Very much pain?
No.
All right.
Yeah. I think the combination of things, we do this and then take a couple of ibuprofen. And the thing you want to do when you hurt like that, you want the pain to go away so you become anxious.
Yes.
Yeah. We all do.
Okay. You
want to
do 10?
Yeah. We're going to do some simple exercise that doesn't look like anything, but it's changed. We call it jump. And there's serious movements that you make that cause you to stretch your body in different ways. So we can start here.
Okay.
Just do what we do.
Okay. You start with your feet together, hands out. Then you step to the left. You bring your feet, hands together. And you slide. And your left hand is on top. You pull out. You lean back a little. Then when you come forward, your fingertips are touching, sort of. And you press up on your toes, looking straight ahead. Then you come down in a circle. This is a transition. You bring your fingers towards you. Then you do a circle and you put your feet together. Come all the way around. Third position. Now, that's number one. Number two is lift, pressing up, pressing down.
push down the earth. Stretch.
Then you come up back together. You press up with your right hand, you press down.
Good. That's the side you need to work on.
Number three, watch. Number three is this. You do the same way. Okay? So number three, punch to the left, block to the right. So it's, and then you block. Okay? And you come back. Now you're going to punch to the right, block to the left. Okay? It's close enough. You come back to the prayer position. Number four, you go down. Your wrists go out, step out to the left.
Well, you're right, step to your left. That's okay.
Yeah. Now you bring your hands up and you push out. This is a riding horse position. Okay? Put your hands together. One hand is your fist, the right hand is your fist. You turn on your right heel to the right. And you come together here. You make both hands fist. And you turn to the left. Back together again. Now then you do a circle. And when your hands come together, you open your fingers and you come up. Then you do another circle and you come down like you're grabbing your cheek. Block with your left, with your hand to your hand, hands with your right, and twist behind, and punch. And come back around. Press with your right, holding your head with the left, and go behind. Come back around. This is your first time. So you bring your hands together like a V to your belly button. You want to turn on your right heel. This is called hitting the corner piece with both feet. Keep your arms kind of good. Then you move back a little. You come forward a little. Keep your hands like this. And you bring it back to your double. Turn on your right heel. You turn on your left heel. And then this side. Lean back a little. Voila. Come forward. Bring the feet to your middle again. And then drop your hands. Number nine. You go and you put your hands behind your neck. Fingertips touching. And you go down as far as comfortable. And you come back up. Cross your arms. Bring your feet together. Go up. Relace your fingers together like so. And you go down as far as comfortable. You open at the elbow. Right? You open a little at the elbow. And you come up, drop down, you open your hands, your palms are up, and then the palms are down.
Good, you see good at
this. Yes,
yeah. Okay. This slow meditative thing helps your body to relax, because when you get, what you have is a spasm. When you have a back spasm, you
put ice on it.
Okay, ice too, but you say it's been going on for a long time. So if you don't do the ice, the minute it happens, then you have to do something else. So,
okay.
Doing the Tai Chi.
Okay. We do just the first few moves of the Tai Chi. And so we're going to face this way. Okay? And let's go a little bit further. And we're going to go towards the kitchen. So, eyes up here, stand here, in the middle,
yes.
Yeah. hand goes forward, this hand goes forward. So this hand, bottom hand, and goes forward, and back hand goes forward. Okay? I'm sure you understood it. So you throw me a punch. Throw me a punch. Okay? So I'm doing this. Okay? That's it. Okay? So your hand goes forward and your back hand goes forward. So you got the ball.
Don't do anything. You start off with complete relaxation. Don't think about anything that hurts. You start off with your left foot. As you move your foot forward, you shift all your weight to the right foot. And land on your heel. When you land on your heel, exhale. When you pick up your foot from the right foot, inhale. Shift all your weight to your left foot. Exhale. Pick up your rear foot. Inhale. Land on your heel, and then you slowly put your foot down. Exhale. Your foot rises. Inhale. Okay. Real simple, but don't think about pain, don't think about anything, just think about nothing. Okay, I was trying to spare him that because. But the important thing is when you land, when you pick up your foot, shift your weight all the way to the one foot and then all the way to the other foot. No, just walk naturally, but I'm just saying shift your weight. So that it goes from one side to the other. Okay, let's do that. Let me stand right in front of you, slightly in front of you, so you can follow me. Should land like a piece of cotton. Exhale. screen?
They're still in the screen. Okay.
This is okay, no problem. This is okay, no problem. But this hurts. See the difference? You could do this, that's no problem, that's no problem. But here, it hurts. And it doesn't take much pressure, you can hurt it. Let's go to the second one. Somebody grab you on the shoulder. Here. Two things you can do. A lot of things you can do. Here. One thing. Just that simple. That's all. And can't come back. Boom. Okay, two. That hurts.
Yeah.
Okay. Here. The thumb. Go against the thumb because it's weak. Okay. Grab it. Go against the thumb. Always go against the thumb. Yeah, there you go.
See? Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. No matter how hard it grabs, go against the thumb.
Okay. Okay. Both hands. Are we still in the screen? Okay.
Yeah.
Both hands here. Open up the gate. That's one. Okay. That's two. The first one is, what did I do?
Open up the gate.
Okay, I go under, behind. That's you. Open up the gate, go under. Good, there you go. Let's continue. Is to break the hold. To grab her, she got you.
Yeah.
So hapkido means that if I grab you, I'm in trouble. I'm in trouble. So I'm gonna grab you, take a step forward with your right foot this way, and then another footstep this way, and then push against my elbow. No. Then push your body against my elbow. No, your body. That, okay. That's it. Don't watch again. I got you. You should bend down. When you do this, Fred, when you do this, try to bend or bring your body around. So. Okay, you're back. But you're not bending your body down. Okay. Bring your foot forward. This one here, stay where you are. This one here is like, you know, aggressive piece. That's like, put your foot forward. Aggressive piece, if they're right handed, you got your lock in.
So quick, it's so
yeah,
easy.
Yeah.
No sweat.
Yeah, the minute anybody gets his knee broken, the fight is over. Okay, if you did it really hard, it would hurt. This way, you just push it. Or this way.
Serious.
This
way. Serious. Yes. Yes. Oh, yes.
Your knee.
In the fight.
your knee is very vulnerable. Because that knee joint, you know, when football players, you see them all the time. It's like, oh, my knee. Mm-hmm. But this is one that takes advantage of that.
And you say, please stay. I'll call the police.
So, why don't you do two things before we watch you? Okay. You go through the whole Tai Chi.
And I'll watch.
And I'll watch you too. Well, I'll go to the Tai Chi. Okay. And then we got another martial art called the Fan. And there's one that old people should use called the Shaolin King. The Shaolin King, which means that somebody walking down the street, the king, is dangerous. But first, Tai Chi.
Okay. We're going to do it the first one the way that my Master Tom taught. And then I'll do the second one, which is 24, which is the way that I do lightness Tai Chi. So, do it. And I'll do a beach at the top of the ball.
It helps you to gain control of your body.
Yeah. This is white crane spreads its wings. This is brush knee, twist step. Brush knee and twist step. Brush knee, twist step. This is strum the loop, breaking the bond. False motion.
These little simple exercises that teach you to shift your weight and do things like exercise different parts of your body without stressing.
Do a little faster than you normally do.
It looks simple and it doesn't look like it's supposed to be like a pop. It doesn't look like you're doing anything, but glad you'll see that it's self-defense. See? Okay, I'm pointing her. just these movements to make it look simple and innocent.
No problem. I'm going to do 24. I'm going to do 24.
This is an advanced form.
Okay, this is with lightning tai chi. It goes down, back out, come up. Amazing making ball. Just step out.
What you're trying to do is create continuous movement so that you can imagine your body will fall away. And you just move and you just have to get out of it. Yeah, good exercise. You can do it forever.
Yeah, I'm
going to
do it
for that. Something you can't do after a certain thing.
Yeah.
You pull it in and punch it at the same time. This is a soft push when you do it as an exercise, but if you push somebody really hard, it takes some breath.
I'm just saying,
The cane. You can imagine this was a nice, strong span. And every part of your body is working out at the same time. The stick is an extension of it. Thank you.
see.
Don't worry, I'm working out with you.
In my, your mind, yes.
I see.
In my mind, your mind, you're working out with me.
Okay. The Chinese invented martial art with a fan. And once again, they have on the end of it, where we can see the fan, it may have metal points at the end, so that you jab.
No, not that one.
Yeah.
Do yours.
If you use it, making it very innocent, but it's a martial art.
You can show him about opening the fan while I do it. Okay. I'm showing you about opening the fan. And I apologize, Master Tom. I am not up to court.
One time?
Yes, please. Okay. we apologize, Master Tom.
Yeah, don't worry.
Thank you. first did it. And when you go for a fan, you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. That's how the 11 spokes.